About its knee position. not change its position with respect to its surrounding. So the boat is said to be, the boat is said to be at rest. Now see, I'm moving means my position is changing with respect to the surrounding. Okay, see, I'm moving means my position is changing. So I'm in motion. So I am in motion. Here the boat does not change its position, so the boat is said to be at rest. So when I'm moving, my position is changing, so I'm said to be in motion. Next, consider one more example. See the clock. See the clock. In the clock, see the numbers on the clock. See, the numbers on the clock are stationary. They does not change the position. It means the numbers are at rest. The numbers are at rest. See the hands of the clock. See the hands of the clock. The hands of the clock are continuously changing their position with the time. It means the hands are in motion. So the numbers are stationary. They does not change the position. So the numbers are said to be at rest. The hands are continuously changing their position with the time. So the hands are said to be in motion. Now we can define the motion. So what is motion? If an object changes its position,
A and B are traveling to Bangalore.
in a bus. And Sid is standing. And Sid is standing along the road. She is standing along the road. Andy are traveling to Bangalore in the bus, and she is standing on the road. Now the bus is moving. Now the bus is moving. The bus is moving means A and B are also moving along with the bus. So, but the A and B does not change the position with respect to each other. Next, with respect to A. B appears to be at rest. With respect to A, B appears to be at rest. And with respect to B, A appears to be at rest. And with respect to A and B, with respect to A and B, C appears to be moving backwards. C appears to be moving backwards, even though it is at rest. And with respect to C, A and B appears to be moving forward. A and B appears to be moving forward. So see here, the rest and the motion, it depends upon the frame of reference. Rest and frame of reference. Rest and motion depends upon the frame of reference. So from these two examples, we can understand that the object which appears to be in motion for one person, it appears to be at rest for another person. The object which appears to be in motion for one person, it appears to be at rest for another person. So we can say the motion is relative. Motion is relative.
Magnitudes.
Then we can measurements of these physical quantities in terms of their numerical values, and these numerical values are called magnitude. So magnitude means the measurements of quantities, the measurements of quantities which are expressed in terms of the numerical values, the measurements of quantities which are expressed in terms of the numerical values are called magnitudes. Next, to describe the sub quantities like the distance, temperature and the speed, we require the magnitude. And but to describe sub quantities like force, in addition to the magnitude, we require direction also. So, suppose if you kick a ball, then the ball begins to move. So the rate of motion of the ball, it depends upon the force applied on the ball. Okay? If you apply less force, then the rate of motion will be less. If you apply the more force, then the rate of motion will be more. So the rate of motion, it depends upon the amount of force.
In the distance, in addition to the distance covered by the object, we will consider
consider the direction of motion, so displacement is a vector quantity. Now, you know what are physical quantities? The quantities which can be measured are called physical quantities. Physical quantities are classified into two types. One is scalar, another one is vectors. Scalar means the quantities which are both in magnitude but no direction are called scalars. Example, speed, distance, area, volume, etc. And vectors, the quantities which have both the magnitude and the direction are called vectors. Example, velocity, displacement, etc. From the point O along the straight path O is. Let
OC minus CO, that is 100 minus 100.
0 km. So when the object is moving from O to C and C to O, the distance covered is 100 plus 100, 200 km. And the displacement is, yeah, both the initial and the final position are same, so the displacement is 0. Next, if the object moves from O to C and C to D, the object moves from O to C and C to D. So if it moves from C to D, see here, this is C, and it is moving from C to D. So what is the distance from C to D? C to O is 100, this is 20, C to D is 120 km. So when the object is moving from O to C and C to D, what is the distance covered? The distance covered is OC. OC plus CD. OC plus CD. OC is 100 km and C to D is 120 km. So the distance covered is 220 km. Next, see the displacement here. This is O is the initial position and D is the final position. So the displacement is OD. Displacement is OD. So OD, we get OD, OC minus CD gives OD. OC is 100, then CD is 120. So OD is minus 20 km. Now the object is, see, the object is moving from O to C. The distance covered is 100 km and the displacement is also 100 km. When the object is moving from O to C and C to B, the distance covered is 160 km and the displacement is 40. When the object is moving from O to C and C to O, the distance is 200 km and the displacement is 0 km. And when the object is moving from O to C and C to B, the distance covered is 220 and the displacement is minus 20 km. Next, what are the differences between the distance and displacement? The distance, it is a scalar quantity. Distance is a scalar quantity. In the distance, we consider only the distance covered by the object, not the direction, so the distance is a scalar quantity. The displacement, it is a vector quantity, because here we will consider the distance covered and also the direction, so displacement is a vector quantity. And the next, the distance, it is always a positive quantity. It is a positive quantity. It means that the object covers some distance. When the object is moving, means it definitely covers some distance. So the distance is a positive quantity. And the displacement, it may be negative also. It may be negative also. And then the distance, it is a actual path. Distance is an actual path covered by the object. The displacement is shortest distance. Between initial position and the final position. And the distance, it depends upon the path. But the displacement, it is independent of the path. It depends only the initial and final position of the object, not the actual path. And the distance is always greater than, or equal to displacement. The displacement in the next class.